Greetings, Eric Bakker, naturopath from New Zealand. Thanks for checking out my video. We're going to talk about gallstones in this series. So this series is going to encompass several videos regarding gallstones. So here's my list. What are gallstones? Signs and symptoms of gallstones. Causes of gallstones. Treatment and diagnosis of gallstones. Best diet for gallstones. Best treatment, etc., etc. So let's talk a little bit about what these things are. You might have heard of the word gallstones and gallbladder, and you know, some people that you've spoken to may have had a cholecystectomy. That's a crazy long word for I've had the gallbladder taken out. So I'll talk about a bit about that in another video. So gallstones basically are little bits of bile, this green sort of stuff that your liver makes, okay, that bunch up with all sorts of junk in the body, and they form. It can form a sludgy kind of a mix, or it can form like little stones themselves, okay? Now the stones can really range in size and in color. You know, look at this lovely picture here. I hope you've had your breakfast. So here's a gallstone picture. Now you can see some brown ones there, and you can see some green ones there. And so the darker ones tend to be really the result of like lots of red blood cell destruction. There's green ones there, and they can encompass all sorts of junk that the body wants to get rid of. Bile is this green liquid that you may have seen before. If you have opened up a fish, or you know, you've cleaned out an animal, or I don't know if you've done stuff like that, but the gallbladder is a small sac that sits around underneath the liver, and its purpose is to collect the bile that the liver produces. So the bile makes up to a pint, or about 600 mils of bile per day. It will actually just make it and channel it through these different canals called canaliculi into bile ducts, and it will go into the gallbladder, and it sits there. It's a nice velvety shaped organ. Don't ask me how I know that, but I've sort of felt a gallbladder before. It's quite a nice soft organ to touch. It's a little pouch, so it holds this green stuff and it secretes it in a bile duct into the small intestine. So bile serves a very important purpose. It helps us to break down and emulsify fats primarily, but it's also a good way for the body to get rid of junk out of the body, okay, through the bile. The biliary route is a classic way, just like the skin. You know, you perspire toxins out, you breathe in and out air. You can also eliminate toxins through the breath, and also no doubt through the urine and through the feces. So the bile is a classic way to get rid of junk. Now, gallstones are the formation, unwanted formation of these things, you know, junk and all sorts of pigments and spent cells. They will accumulate and sit in the gallbladder. Now, these can range from only a few gallstones up to literally many thousands of gallstones can sit in the gallbladder. So the people who are particularly at risk, we'll talk a bit about later on, are females. Women tend to have more problems over men, 2-to-1 in fact. So men tend to have more kidney stones, women tend to have more gallstones. It can also occur more in certain ethnic groups. Pregnancy, oral contraceptive pill use. So there are many reasons why gallstone formation can occur. Right. So the main thing is many people have them. In fact, most people in the Western world will have gallstones to some degree, but only a percentage of about 10 to 15% of people actually are bothered by gallstones. And an even smaller percentage of that 10% will actually go to the ER room or a doctor presenting with discomfort as a result of gallstones. So make sure you watch all the videos in this series, because you're going to learn a lot more about diagnostics and treatment and all these kinds of things. Don't forget to click on the link below if you haven't got my report, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for tuning in.